vessel that God is bringing along Hallelujah. They went the opposite directions. They start to reject you even before you begin to walk. They start to reject you. Somebody shall say, praise the Lord. But instead of just stopping there, of them denying you their meals, of them denying you their waters, oh glory to God, even of them denying you a passage through their land. You are not going to stay in their land. God has given you your own. He's just taking you through that land to get to where he has given you. Somebody shall say hallelujah. Yep, they will not allow you passage through their land. But if they will only stop there, but no, they will not stop. And the scripture said, so they call Balaam, the son of Beor, to curse these people. Somebody shall say hallelujah. Somebody say glory to God. Somebody say the devil is a liar. Because the devil knows what materials or what favor or flavor that God has placed in your life. Yes. What flavor God has placed upon you. Somebody shall say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
He will not want for your flavor, for your fragrance to come out. So he wants to stop you short. He wants to stop you short from the platform where your fragrance will spread and order will draw, your fragrance will draw people to God. Your fragrance will draw people to your platform. The devil wanted to stop the shot from getting there. The devil witness you this morning. Somebody shall say praise the Lord. Or the devil witness you this morning. So the Bible says the enemies called a fortune teller to curse these people. Oh, glory to God. Oh, my goodness. I wonder why David said, if it were not for the Lord be on my side, the enemy would have swallowed me up long time ago, because enemies were in my way. Some of them have been living here on this planet Earth a long time, longer than I've been here. Somebody shall say hallelujah. So they were trying to use their experience to stop me from going to my platform. Somebody shall say glory to God. They were planning to use their influences, all their connections in the natural world and in the demonic world to stop me from getting to my platform. But I thank God in the name of Jesus. And the Lord is here this morning. The Bible said, nevertheless, the Lord God will not hearken unto the fortune teller. Say, never I thank God that he did not listen to the fortune teller. I thank God he did not listen to the witchcraft. I thank God he did not listen to the sorcerer. I thank God he did not listen to the wine goodness, the voodoo wankers. Somebody shall say hallelujah. Because they have witchcraft, they will smile in your face but still want to kill you. They will smile in your face and still want to stab you. Somebody shall say praise the Lord. They owe glory to God. They flatter, flattering world, but they are deadly venoms. Is that right? They owe glory to God. I daily experience it. Say, I was talking to them in peace, but yet war was in their heart against me. Is that right? Oh, yeah, yeah. Despise of your pleasantness. Despise of your peacefulness. Somebody shall say hallelujah. Despise of your godly qualities. Glory to God, glory to God. Jesus said, the Bible said, be wise as a serpent, but be harmless as a dove. Despise of your harmlessness towards them, yet they want to destroy you.
Yes, yes.
They want to cut you short of your platform. Somebody shall say praise the Lord. They want to cut you short of your platform. Say, never I thank God that I am not alone. Oh, glory to God. I thank God all night long that my God has been with me. Woo, hallelujah. My God has been with me, and He never left me, and He will always be with me, because His name is Emmanuel. A God that is with His people. Somebody shout and say hallelujah. God that is with His people. No matter what they want to do, thank God that the Bible says, He that keepeth Israel will neither sleep or slumber. Is that right? My God that is keeping me to not sleep. And He will not slumber. And thank God, the Bible says, the eyes of the Lord are upon those that fear Him. Is that what the Bible says? The eyes of the Lord are upon those that fear Him. The angel of the Lord is kept around those that does what? That fear Him. Some of the challenges, I thank God for His holy angels. Put your hands together and bless the Lord with Him. I thank God. Oh, just be patient with Him. I'm taking you somewhere this morning. Because they met you, they did not meet you to welcome you with their goods, with their bread, with their water, and they start to call witchcraft against you. Hallelujah, they start to conspire against you, trying to stop you from reaching your platform. God said hallelujah. And the Bible said, and then they did not only stop there, but they start to curse you. But the Bible said, nevertheless, the Lord thou God will not listen unto Balaam. But the Lord thou God turned the curse into a blessing. Somebody shouts it, I'm blessed. The Lord thou God turned the curse into the blessing unto you, because the Lord thou God loved you. Say, neighbor, God loved me. Oh, come on, shake him with somebody. Say, neighbor, God loves you. Oh, oh, come on, stand on your feet. Stand on your feet and shake him with three people. Say, neighbor, God loves you. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. It may not look like it, but He loves you. It may not look like it. You may not look that down in trouble, God loves you. Oh, glory to God. You may not look at Ben C, but God loves you. Oh, put your hands together. Say, never, God loves you. You may not look like. Oh, glory to God. You may not look that Jay Z, but God loves you. Oh, put your hands together. Say, neighbor, God loves you. Hallelujah. Yeah. Because if God did not love you, you would not be to where you are now. Say, neighbor, if God did not love you, you would not be to where you are now. You would not have been delivered from the so many battles that you've been through, or so many battles you've been through. If God did not love you, you could have been dead a long time ago, sleeping in your grave, Say, neighbor, God loves you. Because He turned the curse into a blessing. What the devil meant for evil, God turned it into your good. Say, neighbor, what the devil meant for evil, God turned it into your good. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. And then what they said this morning. Say, neighbor, what the devil meant for evil, God turned it into your good. Hallelujah. The glory to God. God did not allow for that sickness to kill you. God did not allow for that hunger to kill you. God did not allow for that depression to destroy you. God did not allow for that migraine to bring you down. God brought you through those things, and now you are much more stronger today than yesterday. You are much more wiser now than yesterday. You are much tougher than what you said this morning. Somebody said, praise the Lord. And then what they said this morning, you could not have made it this far to celebrate another Christmas if God did not love you. Somebody shout, say, praise the Lord. Say, neighbor, you could not have made it this far to celebrate another Christmas if God did not love you. Oh, come on, bless the Lord with me this morning. If God did not love you, God, He turned the curse into a blessing. Hallelujah. He turned the curse into a blessing. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Somebody say glory to God. What the devil meant for evil, God turned it into your good. He turned the blessing. He turned the curse into your blessing. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Oh, yes. They thought they would harm you by not giving you their food.
That's right.
But God said, I can call manna to fall from the sky for my people. They thought they could not, they will harm you for not giving you their water to drink. God said, I speak the right spirit of water for my people. Some of the shall say, hallelujah. I prepare a table before my people in the presence of their enemies. Some of the shall say, I'm blessed. Hallelujah, I'm blessed. He turned the curse into the blessing. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Somebody say, I'm blessed. So God did not stop there. The Bible says, in the name of Jesus, remember what it did to you when you came out of Egypt. God can forgive, but sometimes don't forget. God said, do not forget when you came out of Egypt what it did to you. Nevertheless, the Lord God would not hurt you unto Balaam. But the Lord thy God turned the curse into a blessing unto thee, because the Lord thy God loved thee. Now here God said, yes, you can forgive, but don't forget what it did to you. The sixth verse says, remember what it did to you. Therefore, thou shalt not seek their peace, nor their prosperity, all thou days forever. God said, when you come into your blessings, when you come upon your platform, don't forget what it did against you. Do not seek that prosperity. Oh, glory to God. Do not seek that deliverance. Do not give that which is holy to the dog. Oh, come on, man. Is that right? Do not give that which is... Don't take that time to the Bible here. This power of God is moving this morning. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Do not give that which is holy to the dog. Do not give that which God has blessed to the ungodly. Yeah. Somebody shout, say I'm blessed. Glory to God. I'm so blessed that I will not allow for homosexual to come on now to contaminate my mind. I will not forgive the past ways of witchcraft to contaminate my mind. God said, don't get down, we should hold it to the Lord. Oh, come on now. Somebody shout, say I'm blessed. Somebody shout, say I'm blessed this morning. Don't give that which is holy to the dog. Yes. Give to Jesus what is Jesus. Give to Christ what is Christ. Give to God is God. And give to Caesar what is Caesar. God said, don't give them my holy thing. Don't give them my holy thing. Because they put some curse upon you that you do not deserve. Come on. Somebody shout, say praise the Lord. You were undeserving of their witchcraft activity. You were undeserving of their negative publicity against you. You were undeserving of their conspiracy towards you. So God said, don't forget what they brought you. Never, don't forget. You may forgive, but don't forget that. Don't give them my holy stuff. Honey, I didn't write this Bible. I'm only preaching what the word says. Somebody shout, say glory to God. Don't forget what it did to you. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. My Bible tells me, be not deceived, for God is not mocked. Whatever the man sow, that what he shall reap. Is that what the Bible says? Oh, put your hands together and bless the Lord. Somebody say glory to God. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you. Oh, just be patient with me. I'm taking you somewhere this morning. 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 29. if you would tear within them very quickly. Let me show you something about God's blessings upon his people. So y'all take that child in your life. The power of God is moving this morning. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you. Oh, glory to God. Oh, I feel his presence this morning. Somebody say, Lord, I thank you. 2 Samuel chapter 7, oh yes, verse 29, read these, therefore now let it please thee, oh Lord, I thank you. So somebody shouts it, I'm blessed. Before we go to that, let me read something else to you. Turn to Proverbs 26:2, before we go to that verse. Proverbs 26:2 says, oh yes, as the bird by wandering, as a swallow by flying, so the curse causeless shall not come. In other words, the scripture is saying here, undeserved curse will not land on its intended victims. Oh, glory to God. Undeserved curse will not land on its intended victim. That's the scripture. Let me repeat that once again. When you came from out of Egypt, God began to favor you and began to bless you. Is that right? Yes. And he becomes to turn the curse of the enemies into a blessing on your behalf.
All right.
Is that right? He turned that gossiping of you to your magnification. Oh, glory to God. It's come on up. Sometimes people can advertise you with that negative publicity. You just don't have to worry. Say you do not have a television program. You do not have a radio program. Say you do not have connection with the Joneses to promote you. Sometimes God allows your enemies to promote you with that negative publicity of you, with that negative advertisement. Somebody shall say, hallelujah. God allow your enemy to promote you with that gossip. Is that right? With that backbiting. Somebody shall say, glory to God. If they keep on gossiping so long about you, people will come looking for you to see who is this person. Somebody shall say, hallelujah. And they keep on continuing to talk about you and gossip about you. Welcome that gossiping. God is turning the curse into a blessing for your business. God is turning the curse into a blessing for your promotion. God is turning the curse into a blessing for your elevation. You don't need to be angry. Say, Lord, I thank you. Glory to God. I'm taking you somewhere this morning. So as you about to enter or you are already on your platform, what do you sit there and worry about? Who talking about you? God is turning the curse into a blessing on your behalf. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. The curse is undeserved. You do not deserve such a curse. So the Lord is saying, undeserved curse will not land on its intended victim. Undeserved curse will not land on the intended person, or it will not land on the intended sister, or on the intended brother, because the brother do not deserve. I say, neighbor, you do not deserve. Oh, come on, I say, neighbor, you do not deserve that curse. Glory to God. Somebody shall say hallelujah. Say, devil, I can't receive that package. I did not order that package. I will not receive that package. I don't deserve that. Say, neighbor, you don't deserve that. So I'm taking you somewhere Yes. A curse may have been for your daddy. It may have been your daddy. Oh, glory to God. My goodness. It may have been your daddy. That did thou homosexual stuff, or it may have been your mother that went with that homosexual lesbian stuff. So that curse is not yours, it is hard for me. Say never, you don't deserve that. It may have been your daddy that practiced. Oh, glory to God. Went to bed with a mother and a daughter at a sin. Say never, you don't deserve that. Say, my child, you don't deserve that. Oh, glory to God. Somebody try and say hallelujah. You don't deserve that generational curse. That generational curse may have been in your family before you were born.
That's right.
Is that right? It may have been in your daddy's family before you were born. May the truth be spoken. It may have been in your mother's family before you were born. Say, neighbor, you don't deserve it. You are just an unintended target. Oh, glory to God. Say, neighbor, you don't deserve it. Oh, glory to God. Homosexual practices is not in your mind. They're not in your spirit. The witchcraft practices is not in your mind. It's not in your imagination. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Adultery, they have been your daddy that committed that adultery, adultery lifestyle. With another man, wife, or your mother that may have gone to bed with another woman, husband. Somebody shout, say glory to God. Can I preach this morning? Can I let the Holy Ghost back this morning? Glory to God. Say, neighbor, you don't deserve that. Glory to God. Glory to God. You don't deserve that. Hallelujah. But the devil is a liar. You know what the devil does? Because of some kind of generational curse maybe in the family, the devil wants to continue that curse through the bloodline. Is that right? Because your granddaddy may have done something. You know about the curse of the Kennedys, right? The Kennedy family. So I wish somebody were godly enough to say the boss stand here with me. So glory to God. Because somebody may have been in your family a long time ago that did something stupid or that decided to turn his back on God to do something that was not right in the sight of God. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. To do something that was not pleasant in the sight of God. So the Bible said, be not deceived, for God is not mocked. Whatever a man sow, that he shall reap. Is that right? So now that curse is fell on that family, and the devil wants to continue that curse through all the family. Somebody shall say hallelujah. But you have to be a child of God, inclined enough to tell the devil, no, I am blessed. What God has blessed, no man can curse. God can turn the curse into my blessing. God can turn the curse into my deliverance. God can turn the curse into my youth. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. You can tell the devil, that pocket is not mine. Oh, glory to God. That pocket, say, neighbor, that pocket is not yours. Come on, shake hands with several people, say, neighbor, that pocket is not yours. Oh, resist the devil. He shall flee. Say, neighbor, that pocket is not yours. That curse is not yours. Glory to God. That curse is not yours. Hallelujah. The scripture say, resist the devil, and he shall flee from you. Say, neighbor, that practice is not yours. So now, the devil wants you to receive that package because there are others in your bloodline that were not strong enough to take a stand. That package of pills is still tormenting that family. Somebody was not strong enough to take a stand. That one, witchcraft practicing is still tormenting that family. Somebody was not strong enough to take a stand. That one, poverty is still devastating that family. Somebody was not strong enough to take a stand. That one, death is still stressing. Still, my goodness, invading that family. But somebody may be able to say, enough is enough. I can't hear you. Somebody say, enough is enough. Oh, glory to God. Say, devil, that package is not mine. Go put your hands together. That package is not mine. I'm not going to settle for that package. Say, neighbor, talk to the devil. Say, devil. That package is not mine. I'm not going to settle for that package. I am blessed with what God has blessed. No man can curse. I am healed, and I'm healed indeed. I am rich, and I'm rich indeed. I am free, and I am free indeed. I am delivered, and I'm delivered indeed. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Glory to God. That package is not mine anymore. Say, neighbor, that package is not yours anymore. The curse has been broken. Oh, come on, and say, neighbor, the curse has been broken. The curse has been broken. Come on, come on, I can't hear you. Say, neighbor, the curse has been broken. That package is not yours anymore. You don't deserve that. It was your daddy doing. It was your mama doing. It may have been your brother. It may have been your sister. Whom God set free is free. See? Somebody shouts that I'm free. I can't hear you. Somebody shouts that I'm free. I can't hear you. Somebody shouts that I'm free. Everything that comes my way now should be blessed. Oh, you don't get it. You don't get it. You don't get it. Say, neighbor, God told me I'm blessed. Therefore, I'm blessed. Anything that comes my way now should be all blessed. No more curse. No more curse. No more sickness. No more disease. No more disease. Anything that comes my way now, so this, oh, come on now. Can you share that with three people? Say, neighbor, I can see. Say, neighbor, I can see. Anything that comes your way now, but these blessings, I'm going to finish it with somebody. Say, neighbor, anything, everything that comes your way now. Ooh, my blessings. I see that you were blessing in your life. Say, neighbor, I see nothing but blessing. I see nothing but healing. I see nothing but deliverance. I see nothing but blessing. Everything that comes your way, y'all, shall be blessed. Neither God set free, they're free indeed. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Neither God set free, they're free indeed. Everything that comes your way now. Say, neighbor, I've been empowered. Well, you don't care. Say, neighbor, I've been empowered to speak this over you. Everything and anything that comes your way now will be all blessed. All God blessings. Oh, glory to God. Who is all talking to this morning? Put your hands together and bless. And bless and bless the Lord. We just sang a song that says he came to make his blessing flow far as the curse is far. And that one we just sang a while ago. He came to make his blessing flow far as what? As the curse is far. same day, but the curse has been removed. The Lord come to this morning.
Bless my bloodline. Let it still be
Somebody say yes, Lord. For thou, O Lord, listen to what David is saying. For thou, O Lord, you spoke it. Hallelujah. Thou, O Lord, hast spoken it. Is that right? And with thy blessings, let the house of thou servant be blessed. Whatever God has spoken, Senator, God spoke it on my behalf. Somebody say, Senator, God spoke a word of blessing upon me before I enter my mother womb. Hallelujah. When I came out of my mother womb, God spoke a blessing upon me. Is that right? Now, all these years, God has been protecting me, leading me to my platform. Oh, you don't get it. All these years, God has been defending me, leading me to my platform. Hallelujah. There was a time that I was all by myself. No child, no wife, no family. But God has made an addition in my life. Now I cannot pray just for myself. I got to be inclusive with my family. Now, Lord, when you come to bless me, remember my children. When you come to bless me, remember my grandchildren. When you come to bless me, remember my house. Somebody say yes, Lord.
Now then, hallelujah, what the Lord in remembrance.
shall lift it diligently unto the word of the Lord, thou God, to observe and to do all this commanding, which I command thee this day. Say yes, Lord, that the Lord, thou God, will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. Yeah. So the curse has been broken. Start receiving the negative packages. And look up to the hill from whence coming your head. If you need to do some cleaning in your own home, go ahead and clean your house. Clean your life. Jesus said, go and sin while and sin no more. Stop to stop your growth. Is that right? Don't allow those negative stuff to stop your growth. But God has blessed, no man can curse. Somebody shout, say, I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
Let me show you something. I just about to close. Deuteronomy 23, verse 14. Somebody read it. Deuteronomy, the same chapter, verse 14. Somebody read it. Before you start making this thing up. Around them. 23. Somebody got it here?
23:14.
14, yes.
Okay. It says, for the Lord thy God.
For the Lord your God.
Walk in the midst of thy
camp. Walk in the midst of
it. To deliver thee.
To deliver thee.
And to give up thine enemies before thee.
Okay. Now, read the 23rd verse.
23rd verse says, that which is gone out of thy lips, thou shalt keep and perform.
Yes.
Even a free will offering.
A free will offering.
According as thou hast vowed.
All right.
Unto the Lord thy God, which thou hast promised.
Yes.
With thy mouth.
Yes. Read on.
When thou comest into thy neighbor's vineyard, then thou mayest eat grapes.
What verse were you reading?
24 now.
Let's read verses 12, 13, and 14. Let me show you something.
All right. Thou shalt have a place also without the camp.
Yes. That's, listen to this. This is important, ladies. And brothers, too. When you read on verse 12.
Okay. Whither thou shalt go forth abroad.
When even in the time of battle, in the time of warfare, half a pellet in your hand or a shovel in your hand.
It says, and thou shalt have a paddle upon thy weapons.
Yes.
And it shall be when thou wilt ease thyself upon.
When you go to the toilet,
thou shalt dig therewith.
Dig the ground.
And shall turn back and cover.
Cover your dute.
That which cometh from thee.
Your dute, okay. Cover it up.
Your poop.
Cover it up.
Yep.
That's the reason.
All right.
Cover it up.
Yep. Makes sense. For the Lord thy God.
Yeah, the Lord your God.
Shall walk in.
He will walk.
Where? In the midst of thy camp.
In the midst of your house.
Glory to God. Amen.
In the midst of your house, your camp.
Yes. To deliver you.
To deliver you. And read on.
And to give up thine enemies.
So come on now. To cast your enemies.
Before thee.
Before thee, yeah.
Therefore shall thy camp be holy.
Holy.
That he see no unclean.
No unclean thing.
In thee.
Oh my God.
And turn away from thee.
Okay. Glory. When God is talking about uncleanness, he is not only talking about committing sin.
That's it.
Yeah. Play your role, people.
Right.
It's so holy. You invite it in your house.
Yes.
Oh, some people don't like this.
Preach, Bishop.
Some people don't like this.
Thank you.
Why are you meddling in my business?
That's all right. Preach.
You're seeking God to bless you, people.
Yes. Yes. Say it.
Did coming to visit you. While we sleep and stumble, the angels are walking among us. They have dead clothes hanging everywhere.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say glory to God. I desire